Welcome back to my channel. Welcome if you're new. My name is Hallie and I'm so happy that you're here. Also, Happy New Year! I literally cannot believe it's already 2024, but I'm so excited for this year and just having a fresh, clean slate. I have so many fun plans and expectations for this year, so I'm honestly just like so ready to really get started on a lot of my goals and just things that I wanna do this year. So, speaking of goals and things that I wanna do this year, it is time for my December reading wrap-up and my January TBR, my first TBR for the year of 2024. I'm so excited because the other day, as you guys saw, I went through all the books that I owned and then I reorganized all of my bookshelves, and I feel like going through my books kind of reminded me like everything that I had, and it made me want to read like everything. So it was honestly kind of hard to choose a TBR because I'm kind of in the mood to literally read everything that I own because I'm just like so excited after re-talking about all of them. So let's get right into it. I'm gonna start off with all of the books that I read in December. I'm gonna really quickly go through the books that I had on my December TBR that I didn't end up reading. Honestly, the holidays ended up being so much busier than I expected. Like, I made all these plans, but then I just like didn't realize how busy I would actually be. So I made my TBR like super big and it just was not realistic. So I had 8 books on my TBR and I read 4 of them. So I read half of my TBR. The 4 that I did not get to, Magnolia Parks. I know, this is ridiculous. I've had this on my TBR for 2 months now and I have not gotten to it. Maybe it's just a sign that now is not the right time. So I did not get to Magnolia Parks, unfortunately. Another one that I did not get to, 5 Survive by Holly Jackson, which I'm kind of surprised by, honestly, because I was really, really excited to read this. But I think I was in the mood for a thriller when I put this on my TBR. But then throughout the month of December, like with it being the holidays and stuff, I just never was really in the mood for a thriller. And like in December, I read a bunch of really good fantasies. So it made me in the mood for either fantasy or romance, just like not really thriller. And I feel like that's why I didn't really get around to this. I just like didn't end up being in the mood. I'm a big mood reader, if you can't tell. The next one that I did not get to, How Does It Feel by Janine O'Reilly. This is the same thing as Magnolia Parks. This has also been on my TBR 2 months in a row and I have not gotten to it. So I'm just gonna take it as a sign that this also just is not the right time to try and read this. The last book that I didn't quite get to was actually Assassin's Blade by Sarah J. Maas. I say didn't quite get to because I did actually start it. I started it at our Christmas party, actually. I like snuck away because I had been thinking about it all month and I had been waiting for the right time to start it because I want to be able to really pay attention to this because I know that there's a lot of different characters and storylines and plot developments and whatever. And this is like the first book that I'm reading going into the series. So I really want to be able to like dive into the world and just really be in that world, you know? But like the month of December was just so busy that I never really had that moment. So I snuck away at our Christmas party and I did start it. And honestly, I'm already really, really, really liking it. I only made it, I think, a chapter in, maybe like 2 chapters. But yeah, I'm really liking it, but I'm not putting it on my read list because like I said, I barely made it into this book. So I'm gonna count that as I did not read it in the month of December. So those are the 4 books off my TBR that I did not get to, unfortunately. Moving on to the books that I did read in December though, which honestly, even though there was only 4 of them, I feel like it was such a good reading month for me. To start off, I read Addicted to You by Krista and Becca Ritchie. This is the first book in the Addicted series by them. Honestly, it was so good. When I first started it, I didn't have any idea what to expect because I go into my books blind, so I didn't really know what it was about. And especially this one, it's such a popular series, I really didn't want to know anything about the book. To give you a really short description of what this book is about, it is about 2 childhood friends who grew up in very wealthy families. The girl, her family owns a soda company that is the equivalent to like Coca-Cola, so they're very well off. And then the guy, his family is the equivalent to like Johnson & Johnson's. Like, they make everything you could ever need for baby stuff. But they grew up together and have been friends like literally since they were in elementary school, I think. And both of them developed addictions to different things at a young age. The guy, Lauren Hale, she calls him Lo, he became an alcoholic at a very young age. I mean, he wasn't a full-on alcoholic whenever he was a kid, but like obviously it was growing into that. Like, he had an addiction already. He was drinking when he should not have been drinking, and he was drinking a lot. And then the girl, Lily Calloway, she actually became addicted to sex. As weird as that sounds, that's a real thing. Hers is the same way. Like, it didn't start off that way, but she will say like in the book, I always knew I wasn't the same as other girls. So anyway, they grow up best friends. They know about each other's addictions, and eventually eventually, whenever they become adults and go to college, they make an agreement that they will fake date and keep each other's addictions a secret from each other's family. That way they can like live their lives in peace and enjoy their addictions without any of their family knowing or giving them a hard time. And then eventually one day they realize that maybe they do have feelings farther than just fake dating. And then you spend the rest of the book exploring their relationship together and their challenges with their addictions and stuff like that. So honestly, I ended up enjoying this so much more than I thought I would, and I gave this a 4.25. I definitely feel like this was a really good first book to the series, and it has me very interested to get farther into the series. Definitely would recommend this one. Also, the entire Addicted series is available on Kindle Unlimited if you have Kindle Unlimited. The next book, Powerless by Lauren Roberts. This book is so good. Like, honestly, the longer that I think about it, the more I feel like I would maybe rate this like a 5.5. I don't know. It feels excessive to say 6 stars because I haven't read that many books. So I'm like, okay, am I just easy to impress or is this like that good? Because thinking back on it, I always think like that is a 6-star read. Like, it was just so good. This book is about Peyton and Kai. They live in a society where everyone has like these powers, and people who don't have powers are called ordinaries, and they've basically been outlawed because the government believes that if the people with powers get married and have kids with people who don't have powers, that eventually the bloodline will run out and then there will be no more people with powers. So they have outlawed everyone without powers. They basically like execute you if you don't have powers. Peyton does not have powers, but her dad taught her from a very young age to hide the fact that she does it, and so she pretends to have a power so nobody actually knows she is an ordinary. So one day something happens and she ends up landing herself in the trials, which the trials is kind of like Hunger Games, except for you have to basically show off your powers and compete in these deadly games. But the problem is she doesn't have powers, so it's like, girl, how are you gonna get through that? It was just so good. The banter in this is truly unmatched. Like, Lauren Roberts' writing style is so beautiful. I don't think I've ever read a book that was beautifully written the way that this was. The descriptions of everything are just so beautiful. And I think about Kai and Peyton every single day. I love them so much. But yeah, this was honestly, I feel like, a 6-star read for me. This might be my favorite book that I've read of the year. Would definitely recommend. I'm so excited for the second book to come out this summer. Another book that I read this month is Carval. This is the first book in the Carval trilogy. So there's two other books after this one. This one follows two sisters and they get a letter from Grandmaster Legend or something like that, that they get to participate in this year's Carval, which is like, I think it's a 3 or 5 day event or something like that, where they do illusions and like you basically get to experience magic firsthand. But this year's Carval is different. Basically, the puzzle that they're trying to solve is different than any other Carval. Yeah. I don't know how to explain it better than that without giving it away, but honestly, I enjoyed this a lot more than I thought I would. I really was only reading the Carval series because I want to read Once Upon a Broken Heart. Everyone says that you don't have to read the Carval trilogy before Once Upon a Broken Heart, but people say that they recommend it because it adds a lot of just backstory and extra information into the world and some of the characters that are in Once Upon a Broken Heart. So I didn't have too high of hopes for this, honestly, because I'm just reading it to get to another series, but I ended up enjoying this a lot more than I thought I would. It's definitely not the best fantasy that I've ever read. It just didn't feel as immersive as books like Fourth Wing or Powerless, but it definitely was good. Like, it wasn't bad. I rated this a 3.75, and that still feels accurate to me because like it just feels a little bit above middle of the road, which to me, like, a 3 is like, it's not the best thing, but it's definitely not bad. Like, I would recommend this. I'm just not gonna read it again. I probably won't think about it too often. What pushed me to give it a 3.75, I think, is the ending, because I really enjoyed the ending and I didn't see it coming. And then lastly, I read Divine Rivals by Rebecca Ross. This is another one. It's just so good. Like, this is living rent-free in my brain. And it's so funny because, first of all, I rated this 5 stars, but it's so funny because when I first started this book, I didn't have very high expectations because all I knew about it was that they write letters back and forth to each other. So I was like, oh, like, that's kind of cutie. It'll just be like a cutie little story, whatever. Like, halfway through the book, I was like, you know, this definitely isn't bad. Like, it's not a bad book. It's just like not much is happening. And so I was starting to feel a little bit like, oh my gosh, like, am I not gonna like this? I'm gonna be so disappointed. But then out of nowhere, genuinely out of nowhere, I'm like 3/4 through the book and I have butterflies and I'm like giggling and I'm like thinking about the characters whenever I'm not reading, and all I can think about is reading this book. And by the end of it, when I tell you, I cried, I laughed, I gasped, I just love this book so much. I love these characters, enemies to lovers, and it's just like, I've thought about this book every day too. It's just so good. It's just so good. And it's so good. And I'm so sad because the second book came out and I ordered the UK version of this. And so I'm sitting here like waiting for it to get in the mail because I'm like, hello, the book is out. Like, send me the book. I need to read the story. I check and it says it's getting published in April. So I'm like, oh my God, am I gonna have to wait until April to read this freaking book because I wanted the UK cover? And honestly, that's what I get for being picky. Did I need the UK cover? No, but did I want it because it's so cute? Yes. So yeah, those are all the books that I read in December. I feel like even though it wasn't that many books, it still was such a good reading month, and I'm really happy with the books that I did read because I really loved all of them, honestly. I feel like that's such a good month of reading. So moving right along, I'm so excited to show you guys the books that I have picked for my January TBR. This is like so exciting because I started reading in October of last year, so this will be my first full year of reading. This is like the first time that I get to do like a new year first TBR of the year. I don't know, I'm just so excited. So starting off actually with a Kindle book, which feels so random, but it's actually The Fake Out by Stephanie Archer. This is the second book in a hockey romance series. I don't remember what the series is called, but I read the first one called Behind the Net. It was like one of my first reading vlogs that I posted, and I rated that 5 stars. It was just like the cutest little like kick your feet. I have butterflies. I am giggling. I love this man. I love them together. I love this story. Love everything about it. And then a couple weeks ago, someone commented that she came out with a second book in the series, which I didn't even realize that there was going to be any more books in that series. Like, I just read Behind the Net and I was like, wow, I love you. And then moved on with my life. So that was such a fun surprise. And the other night after finishing editing, I randomly started the book just to like have something to read before bed. And when I tell you, I read for like 7 hours straight, I almost finished the book. So I am including that on this month's TBR because I want to finish it. I think I only have like 3 hours left in the book. I honestly might just finish that tonight after I'm done recording this because I just want to see how it ends. I am loving it so far. I really think I'm such a big fan of Stephanie Archer's writing. I want to read some of her, I think it's called a backlog, like whenever you go back and read her books that have come out previously. But I think I want to go back and read some of her backlog at some point this year because at this point, both of her books that I've read, The Fake Out and Behind the Net are, well, The Fake Out is looking like it might be another 5-star read for me, honestly, but Behind the Net was also a 5-star read. So I'm like, I obviously really like her writing. So I kind of want to go back and see what else she has and see if I like it as much. So that is the first book on my TBR for January. The next book that I have on my January TBR is actually Heartless by Elsie Silver. This is the second book in the Chestnut Springs series. This book actually follows Cade Eaton, which is the older brother of Rhett Eaton, I think, which is the main character in the first book. I am so excited to get into this. This is a single dad trope and a lot of people love Cade Eaton's character. I'm just very excited to get back into this world. I ended up loving Flawless so much more than I thought I would. I was kind of unsure about cowboy romances because I just like didn't know how I would feel about that. But honestly, I ended up liking it so, so much. So I'm very excited to get back into the world of Chestnut Springs and see how I like the rest of the characters. That's all I have to say about that one. The next book is Shatter Me by Tahara Mafi. This is the first book in the Shatter Me series. I am so excited to get into this. Literally since I first started posting book videos, this is like one of the most recommended series that you guys want me to read. And so this is highly anticipated for me. I really, really, really hope that I like this. If you don't know, this book is about Juliet, who has a special power to where like anything she touches dies, I think. And the government is trying to use her as a weapon. So I read the first page and the first page is literally her and she's like, I've been locked up for 264 days. So it just follows her, I guess, and maybe like her quest for freedom or how the government uses her, or I don't really know, but it sounds very interesting. And obviously you guys love it so much, and honestly everyone on the internet loves the series so much, so very highly anticipated read for me. I really hope that I like this so that I can read the rest of the Shatter Me series. The next book is Hooked by Emily McIntyre. So this book feels so random to me to be holding because I never thought that I would read this book. book. This is actually like a Peter Pan retelling, I think, except she writes it in the perspective where, I don't know what I'm talking about. I think it's the antagonist, but basically like the bad guy. The bad guy in the story is written to be the main love interest, so you end up liking and rooting for the bad guy. I wasn't gonna read this, so I don't really know, but what convinced me is I've seen a couple of people talk about it on their vlogs, and then the other day I was at the bookstore. This girl was helping her friend choose books. I'm assuming she was a new reader because she was telling her about all these books in the aisle, and she was just going on and on about how this book was so good and it's such a bingeable book, and she read it in one night, and the spice is amazing and the romance is amazing and the story is amazing, and she convinced me. I was way too shy to like say anything, so I quietly waited for her to leave the aisle before I grabbed this, but she fully convinced me, and so now I'm actually excited to read this book because of how she was hyping it up to her friend. So thank you, random lady at the bookstore. Thank you. The next book on my TBR is yet another romance. It is Love Theoretically by Allie Hazelwood. This one I have been thinking about since November, because in November I read like 2 chapters of this randomly one night, and then I put it back on my shelf and just forgot that I did that. I'm very excited to get farther into this. The premise of this book is so interesting. It's basically about this girl. She has a side job where you can hire her to be your fake girlfriend. So if you have to go to a family event and you have like a really judgmental family and you don't want to show up single, you can like hire her. Or if you have a work event and you don't want to go by yourself, you can hire her to go with you. She literally just like goes on a date with you basically, and you pay her. And in this, I think she ends up falling for one of her client's brothers. So that's cutie patootie. And honestly, from the first 2 chapters, I was already so vibing with this. So I am very, very excited to get farther into this book this month. The next book, another romance, but I put this on my TBR, one, because I really want to read Wildfire in February, I think for like Valentine's Day, because like that would be cute. And this book technically comes before that. I know that they're interconnected standalone, so I don't have to read this before Wildfire, but my brain just like, I feel like I have to read them in order. I just feel like I have to. Plus, after reading The Fake Out and loving it so much, I felt like I might be craving another hockey romance. Something about hockey romance, I just love it so much. So I put this in my TBR in case I am left wanting more hockey romance vibes after The Fake Out. This is about a character who, I think she's trying out for like the US Olympic, what is that called, figure skating, and something happens to where the practice times of the figure skating and the hockey team like intertwine, and then she meets this guy and they become enemies. So it's like enemies to lovers. I think that's the gist of this story, but I'm not 100% sure on that, so don't quote me, but I think that's what that's about. The next book on my TBR for January, which also this is such a big TBR, it's like super ambitious, and I think it's just because coming out of the holidays, I'm so excited, like I've said a million times, just to get into the new year and really start working on my goals and getting through books, and just, I don't know, I'm just so optimistic about this next year, which I feel like is how everyone feels at January, and then you just spend the rest of the year fighting for your life. But it's okay, I'm gonna be optimistic while I can. Anyway, the next book on my TBR is The 7-Year Slip by Ashley Poston. This one is about a girl whose aunt dies, and then she ends up moving into her aunt's apartment, and whenever she walks into the apartment, it goes 7 years in the past, and there's a man living in her aunt's apartment. It's a book with like magical realism, and I guess you're just trying to figure out like, who is this man? What is he doing here? How is this happening? I don't know, but everyone like raves about this book, so I am very, very, very excited to read this. And then the last book on my January TBR is honestly kind of a very different vibe than the rest of the books that I have on my TBR, but I just wanted to put it on here in case I end up craving something like this after so much just like romance. 6 of Crows by Lee Dubargo. This again is like a huge one that you guys are constantly recommending to me in the comments, and I know that this is a very, very loved book also. It's a duology also. So there's 6 of Crows and then Crooked Kingdom, but this follows a group of, I think it's 6. Yep. Right on the front, it says 6 dangerous outcasts, but it follows 6 misfits, and they're all like criminals, and they have different, not abilities, but they have different like specialties, I guess. Like they're each really good at doing a specific thing, and they band together to pull off this heist that will like make them extremely rich. That's all I know about it, but people say the plot in this book is just so good and so well thought out, and that's something that I realize I really appreciate in books, is like plot twists and deeper meaning to things and stuff like that. Like that's why I really love mystery thrillers. So I honestly have really high hopes for this book. I really think that I will like this. So, okay, these are all the books on my January TBR. Hi, excuse me, I just realized I forgot to say Assassin's Blade is also on my TBR for this month. Yes, this is so ambitious, but there's no way that I could not add this to my TBR, but I feel like that was a given, so maybe that's why I forgot to say it. Anyway, this is also on my TBR. That's all I had to say. Okay. I'm so excited to get into this month of reading. If you guys want to see reading vlogs for any of these specifically, let me know in the comments. Also, I would love to know what some of the books that you guys have on your TBR are. I'm so interested to see what everyone else is starting off their new year of reading with, and maybe I can get some ideas from you guys. But yeah, I love hearing from you in the comments. And if you do want to see reading vlogs for any of these books also, make sure to subscribe and turn on your notifications so that you don't miss those in the future. I hope you enjoyed, and I will see you guys in the next one. Bye.